Hello, Marvel gaming fans, and as well as Avengers fans. Welcome to back to LEGO Marvel Adventures again, and to my short little new mini-series of the DLC of LEGO Marvel Adventures. So, last time, as you guys remember, we finished the whole story, we did everything, you know, I did the whole main story. So now that's all that's left is the DLC levels, and there are a couple of packs, but only six of them have a story, or a level, as I, whichever one you want to go by. So, I will be doing six levels of different characters. So, the first one I'm going to be doing, as you can probably see, is Ant-Man. And that's because Ant-Man came out first after Avengers Age of Ultron, so I wanted to do him first, just to, you know, be fair. And because it's kind of ironic, because Ant-Man 3 is actually coming out soon, and I like the Ant-Man character, and I want to... I believe the level, or at least the story, should be based on something from the first movie. Since this came out, you know, around after Age of Ultron, so... Yeah, there's Ant-Man. Doctor Strange is going to be the next one. He's going to be the second level. Then you have Black Panther. You have Captain Marvel. You have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And then you have the Masters of Evil as the last one. So I would say the main three that I'm probably going to be the most excited for is Ant-Man, Doctor Strange, and Black Panther. Captain Marvel I'm okay with. Not a huge fan of. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I've never seen the show. S.H.I.E.L.D. is not very much of an organization that I'm too interested in, so I probably won't be that big on it. Masters of Evil just seems to be about villains that I've heard of, like Baron Zemo, who's a Captain America villain. So, I mean, at the end of the day, but I'll still play them, and I'll still see if I like them, and we'll see if it works. But yeah, like I said last time, we finished the main story, we defeated Ultron, so now we can enjoy the DLC levels, and there will be six total, so you can look forward to that. So if you guys want to see me do the other levels with Doctor Strange, Black Panther, Captain Marvel, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and Masters of Evil, you know, do say that by either giving me a like on this, or a comment, or, you know, just the support, just so that I know that you guys are, you know, are interested in this. But anyway, let's not waste any more time. Let's dive in to the level. I hope you guys checked out my previous Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir videos. Enjoy those. I'll be working on Sleepy Hollow videos for this month after this. So I'll mention that at the end. But yeah. So let's go. Let's see if Ant-Man's story is interesting and a good take on the original film. So yeah, let's begin. So, story? Are you sure? Yes.
Okay, so get this. Remember last week when I had to bail from the ballet, bro? And you know how much I dig my man Prokofiev and his unorthodox use of harmonies. Well, my boy Scotty was coming back to town, and I had to be there for him, you know? Just like he was for me and stuff. Anyway, I'm like, there's this sweet gig I got lined up with some friends of mine, bro. But he's all like, are you for real right now? No way am I gonna be some loser bad guy no more. So I say, they're like real skilled people, man. And he just says, I don't think so. And I'm all like, yo, Scotty, whatever, bro. Then he got fired from his job and he's all like, let's eat waffles and do this thing. So we find our way into this old dude's house. This job I heard through my cousin's friend's brother's girl. So he finds his suit, bro, and then things start getting crazy, you know what I'm saying? Yo, I'm sorry. I'm just getting excited, you know? This dude named Cross wants to use the tech and make suits called Yellowjackets and sell them to major shady dudes, like take over the world shady. So me and Scotty, we hit up Pimp Tech so he could stop them.
Oh,
Oh man, we were in, and Scott's lady friend had set me up with a security clearance, and I was in the system.
There
man.
We go, Scott in his Ant-Man outfit. Man, anything, he looks good. Like, Ant-Man is a great. I've actually never played the DLC level, so unlike the main story, like, this is gonna be very new for me. Very, very new. Like, I've never seen. Well, I've seen the Ant-Man movie. I've never played the DLC level. I actually didn't know there was one, so it's actually pretty cool. Alright, so Louise, I think, has to go through this one.
Access granted.
Yes, thank you for the tip. Looks like this is for Scott. Alright, Scott, let's go. Oh, we get to shrink down. Yeah, look at this.
I gotta be honest, man. Seeing Scotty do his thing was incredible. He explained that even though he was small, he was still like mad strong, you know? And he explained it for like an hour, but I was thinking about smoothie machine.
Did it work? Looks like it did work. Took down the security. There we go. Let's go, Scott. So yeah, you get a lot of characters from these packs from the each of the movies. So from Ant-Man, you pretty much get all of, you get Scott, you get Hank, you get Hope, you get Louise.
We can handle it. We're professionals.
I think you even get one of Ant-Man's, like, cute, ant buddies, like, as, like, one of the playable characters, which is cool. You could tell, like, it's really cool actually having the little ants around, too. Oh, that's so cool. That it's very much like the movie where like Scott just shrinks and like comes up and like that was pretty funny. Like, did he go down his pants or something like that? That's kind of. I like that I can even like shrink down and like kind of shake up the gameplay if I want to, go from big to small and like do that. Yeah, fuck you. Sorry, Louise. I thought you were someone else. All right, Luis, you're up. Come on. There you go.
Access granted.
Real hero should never be
Okay, so Scott's gotta go down here.
This place was full of high-tech gear, like straight-up stuff from the future. And if anyone could get it to work for us, Scotty could.
I'm going in your pants, buddy. Oh, look, I'm over here. Now I'm not. I love the shrinking ability. Like, it's so much fun, like, just shrinking in and out whenever I want to. Really spices up the gameplay. Ooh, wait, was I supposed to do that? Well, whatever.
Granted.
Clearly, I'm supposed to go in here. Okay, yeah, this is a shrinking one. But hold on, I can't, you know, do it yet because I have to turn off the air. Oh shit! Okay, Luisa's got to do it. Okay. Go, Scott. I hear him, but I don't see him.
We needed to get to the Yellowjacket, but the whole place was locked down tighter than Alcatraz. And there ain't no prison that could hold us, except maybe that last one. But that was pretty good.
I got you, Luis. Oh, Stanley in there?
No.
Okay, so I can't change characters when I get into a level. That was by accident. Sorry, Stan.
I'm sorry, I was thinking about the elevator music. It captivated me. We made it! Once we got past security systems around the chamber, it was time to show some of Scotty's new bomb moves to that cross dude.
No. I knew these. No.
No. Access granted.
Can't get past there, so it's most likely Louise has to shoot these to get me past. Okay, I gotta get Scott through there. Okay. Alright, let's see if I can get Scott up, down. Scott needs to go down for this one. Up we go, Scott. Come on. What the fuck? Okay. Oh, wait. Hold on. I think I know what I did. I think I put this one. Was the right one. I think I have to time it with the leaves. There we go. Now Scott's in.
So, turns out Cross put on that yellow jacket suit. And it's like fresh tech, bro. I mean, Scotty's suit can't even fly. But that don't stop him.
Time to face the yellow jacket. I'm gonna kick your ass, Yellow Jacket.
Scotty was like blam, and then Yellow Jacket, he went like bam, and then Scotty was like boom. I just wish I could have actually seen it. So Ant-Man, he got all ambushed and stuff, but my man, you know, he managed to fight his way out. And he let that dude have it, you know, like bam, bam, bam. And with some help of some, like, really skilled people, you know, he saved the day, man. It feels kind of weird, you know, but I think I can get used to this good guy stuff. Anyways, I gotta go. I'm late to meet my cousin Ignacio at the museum.
Ant-Man. I gotta say, that was a pretty fun little level. Luis has never been a favorite character of mine. I don't really... His character's okay, but not really something that I'm that big on. So him narrating over anything is not exactly the most fun thing in the world. It would have been cool to actually hear Paul Rudd's Scott Lang voiced in there. But I guess maybe that would have been too much for them. Anyway, yeah, that was it for Ant-Man's level, and I gotta say, I pretty much enjoyed the level. I thought it was fun and entertaining, and, you know, Ant-Man's fighting style was really cool. Like, the fact that I could just shrink down and up whenever I wanted to, and, you know, kick the guard's ass was really fun. So I definitely would recommend the Ant-Man level if you want a nice little level where you can just shrink down and up. It's a nice variety of gameplay, and it's pretty fun. I'm not a fan of Luis's character, but it's still cool hearing his voice. I mean, but again, like I him narrating over everything isn't exactly the best thing in the world, but I get why they did it. Like, it's kind of a trope with the Ant-Man movies. Like, they have him narrate a lot of shit. But we'll see how the other levels go. I think overall this one's not too bad. Definitely would play. I definitely would recommend getting the Ant-Man DLC if you want to, you know, try it for yourself and check it out. And yeah, that's going to be it for this video. Next time I'll do Doctor Strange's level. We'll see how the Sorcerer Supreme is done in his level. Hopefully it'll be good. Hopefully we'll get some nice magic trickery with him. But it was pretty fun playing as Ant-Man. I had fun, you know, just shrinking up and down, you know, kicking all the guards' ass, and, you know, a little fight with Yellowjacket. You know, it's just, you know, typical button mashing, not really any uniqueness to it. But hey, what are you going to do? Not everything's perfect. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like if you did. If you enjoyed this DLC level, comment down below your thoughts on the level itself, if you thought it was, you know, what you think of it, and if you want to see more of these, the other five levels, if you want to see me play the other five levels, I'll definitely do that. And, you know, just if you have any tips on how I could do better in the game, you can also do that as well. You know, just anything. You can leave your thoughts in the comment section below. And subscribe for more Marvel gaming content like this. I do love playing Marvel video games. They're always fun and entertaining to do, especially when they're either based on... I prefer the original ones because it's really cool seeing the original stories, but I'm happy with, you know, adaptations if they're done well. And this level is pretty much just an adaptation of the final, like, the third act of Ant-Man. Summarizes most of the movie. We get to play a little bit of the third act, and then, you know, that's pretty much it. That's kind of what I expected. We didn't have multiple levels like with Avengers, so I'm not expecting, you know, us to play through the whole game, you know, through the whole movie. That would be cool, though. I would have loved, you know, multiple levels, you know. It definitely would have been worth it, but, it was fun. You know, I had a great time playing, you know, a little Ant-Man level, and, you know, it's the closest we'll get to an Ant-Man game at this point, at least. Maybe in the future we'll get, you know, an original Ant-Man game. Who knows? Like, that'd be pretty cool. And hopefully Ant-Man 3 will be a very entertaining film, because I'm actually really excited to see what they do with the Ant-Man character in the final, you know, I assume the final solo entry in the series, since besides Thor, they don't really do... The heroes don't usually get past three movies, so I'm suspecting this will probably be Ant-Man's final solo outing, and hopefully it'll go out on a bang. The first two Ant-Man movies, you know, have their ups and downs, but I don't think the first two of any... either of them have really wowed me, so hopefully this one will be the best one of the trilogy, but we'll see how it goes. I mean, I'm excited to see where the Ant-Man character goes and what his future will hold. But, yeah, if you're into Marvel gaming, like the Avengers, or you just even like the Ant-Man character, you know, you can subscribe for more Marvel content like this, because I will be covering the Ant-Man movies in the future. And, you know, talking about the first two films when I get to that point. And if you can follow me on Facebook, where I have, you know, discussions about things we talk about on, you know, both of my channels. I just uploaded a video on my B&E Sports, you know, on my second channel, B&E Sports. I uploaded my Patriots highlight video, so if you want to go check that out. You know, if you're a Pats fan and you enjoyed the Patriots, then you can go check that out and, you know, tell me what you think of it. And, you can also follow me on Twitch, where I hope to live stream in the future. But yeah, in my next video, I will do my review of Season 1, Episode 6 of Sleepy Hollow. So we'll be going, since we're now in February, we're now going to be starting with Sleepy Hollow, and I'm excited to get back to talking about it. And, you know, giving my thoughts on it. So if you're interested in hearing my thoughts on Season 1, Episode 6 of Sleepy Hollow, you can go check it out when it releases. It should be probably next week, since I doubt, you know, I'll have a video up by, you know, after, you know, today. But, you know, usually I have one video a week, because it takes a lot of, you know, I work on a lot of stuff, you know, ahead of time. So I'm actually, you know, working on, you know, my future book reviews for Scooby-Doo for the summer special, and I'm working on a future Friday the 13th movie review for when the next Friday the 13th rolls around. So a lot of future projects coming the way, but thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you had a good time. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you hopefully in the next DLC level, and hopefully we'll get to play, you know, more of these, and we'll see you. We'll see how good the other ones are. I don't think all of them are movie-based. I'm pretty sure Doctor Strange's one is actually original, which is cool. I think Ant-Man's and probably Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. will probably be the only two that are probably based on the TV show and the movies that are on. But I think the other ones should be original stories, which is cool. I'm actually really excited to see what these original stories will be, and if they're you know, good little stories that are worth, you know, getting. So, but we'll see. Thank you guys for watching, and as always, peace out.